Bibliophiles of the internet, I'm Adri, and today I'm here to bring you another installment of the A to Z of Queer Lit. Last time I did this was December 2020, I think, and there are so many new queer books that we definitely have enough to do another update. This challenge of sorts was created by the one and only George Lester, who is the now published author of Boy Queen. I will link his video down below, along with my most recent installments, so definitely check those out. In case you don't know, this challenge is pretty simple. You name one queer book for every letter of the alphabet, and that letter has to appear either in the author's name or in the title of the book. I decided to make this list entirely out of new 2021 queer releases. Some I've read, some I haven't yet, and I thought it'd be a fun way to like round up some new queer books that you definitely don't want to miss. As always, this list is not intended to be definitive nor exhaustive. There are way more than just 26 new queer books for this year, and it should go without saying that just because a specific book is not in this specific video does not mean that it does not exist. With that said, let's get started with A, which is for Almost Flying by Maia, Arlow. This is a sapphic middle grade story about two soon-to-be stepsisters, Dahlia and Alexa, whose parents want them to spend the summer doing some kind of bonding experience. Alexa was planning an amusement park road trip that Dahlia ends up crashing, but Dahlia also decides to invite a girl from her swim team who is both a potential friend and crush. B is for Boys Run the Riot by Gaku, Keito. This series is created and written by a trans mask mangaka, and it's about a Japanese trans boy who's obsessed with streetwear, and when he runs into the new transfer student at a pop-up store, the two of them decide that they should collaborate and create their own streetwear brand themselves. C is for The City Beautiful by Aden, Polydoros. Set against the backdrop of the World Fair in Chicago 1893, this follows Alter, who's a Romanian immigrant and also Jewish. His best friend, Yakov, becomes the latest victim in a long line of murdered Jewish boys, and as Alter tries to get to the bottom of this case, he finds himself possessed by Yakov's vengeful Dibbuk. D is for the newly re-released Peter Darling by Austin Chance. It's a trans reimagining of the Peter Pan mythos. It supposes that Peter was once Wendy Darling, but he escapes back to Neverland when he realizes that it's the safest place for him to exist as he is. But in the 10 years that have gone by, the Lost Boys, the pirates, and the island itself are completely different. E is for Gender Euphoria, edited by Laura Kate Dale. It's an anthology of essays by transpec authors from a wide variety of identities and experiences in which they share moments that have brought them gender euphoria, which not only decenters gender dysphoria as the primary means of parsing transness, but also redefines what gender euphoria can look like. F is for In Deeper Waters by F.T. Lukens. This is a queer historical fantasy adventure. It follows Prince Tal, who's desperately trying to hide his powerful, dangerous, and very forbidden magic. After living a very sheltered life hidden away in the palace, he finally embarks on his coming-of-age tour, only to be almost immediately kidnapped for ransom by pirates. But I will once again say that this is not about queer pirates. G is for We Are Not Broken by George M. Johnson. This is George M. Johnson's latest piece of YA nonfiction. It's kind of like a love letter to their grandmother who raised them along with their siblings. It's about the different experiences George had growing up as a black kid in America and how they came to understand family, love, and sacrifice. H is for The Heartbreak Bakery by A.R. Capetta. It's a very queer and magical story about Sid, who has the ability to bake emotion into food. So when Sid bakes a batch of post-breakup brownies at work, everyone who eats them starts breaking up, including the owners of the queer bakery where Sid works. Now Sid and the very cute new delivery person will have to figure out the perfect recipe to fix this mess. I is for Ace of Spades by Faridah, Àbíké-Íyímídé. This is an intense mystery thriller about Devon and Chiamaka, who are the only two black students at a very prestigious private academy known as Nivius. An anonymous texter calling themselves Aces is suddenly threatening to expose students' worst secrets, and they announce Devon and Chiamaka as their first targets. J is for The Jasmine Throne by Tasha, Suri. This is a sapphic fantasy inspired by the epics of India, and it follows a captive princess named Malini. She is desperate to unseat her traitorous brother, who's become a dictator over their kingdom. So she teams up with a maidservant who she discovers to have very powerful and very forbidden magic. K is for The Ghost We Keep by Mason Deaver. It's about a non-binary character named Liam, whose older brother Ethan was tragically killed in a car accident. As Liam begins to feel more distant from their two best friends and also his family, they realize that the only person who can really understand their grief and maybe help him move on is actually Ethan's best friend, Marcus. L is for A Clash of Steel by C.B. Lee. This is a Treasure Island remix set in China during 1826, and it's about Jiang, who desperately wants to prove herself to her mother and become independent. Her chance finally arises when she realizes that the pendant her father left her contains a rare map leading to the treasure trove of a legendary pirate fleet. M is for Summer Suns by Lee Mandelo. This is a blend of dark academia and queer Southern Gothic. It's about Andrew, who was secretly in love with his best friend Eddie, who tragically and mysteriously passed away. Without any time to grieve, Andrew finds himself inheriting Eddie's unfinished research, his house, his fortune, and also his vengeful ghost. N is for The Chosen and the Beautiful by Nghi. It's a magical retelling of The Great Gatsby as told from Daisy's best friend Jordan Baker, who is queer and a Vietnamese immigrant. She becomes associated with Gatsby, who may have sold his soul to a demon, and becomes roped into his reckless schemes to win Daisy back. O is for The Hellion's Waltz by Olivia Waite. It's a queer historical romance about Sophie, who's a straight-laced musician trying to start over in a new town after her family's piano shop went out of business. She ends up befriending a beautiful silk weaver named Maddie, who's secretly planning one last heist, and Maddie decides if she can't avoid entangling herself with Sophie, she might just have to seduce her to the cause. P is for Payback's a Witch by Lana, Harper. It's an adult sapphic rom-com about Emily, who's been estranged from her family and hometown for many years, but an infamous spellcasting tournament hosted by her own family is what finally brings her back. There, she learns that not only is she still mad about the town's notorious playboy Gareth breaking her heart, but he's also more recently screwed over Emily's best friend and also a wickedly charming witch named Talia, and now Talia wants Emily to join them in getting revenge. Q is obviously for The Queer Principles of Kit Webb by Kat Sebastian. This is a queer adult historical rom-com about a retired highwayman named Kit, who's just trying to run his coffee shop and live out a quiet existence. When he's propositioned by an annoyingly haughty and arrogant nobleman named Percy to steal an item of great importance, he decides to instead teach Percy everything he needs to know to pull off this heist. R is for Rise to the Sun by Leah Johnson. This is about Olivia and Tony, who meet each other at a summer music festival by chance. Olivia wants to win the festival's infamous scavenger hunt, and Tony wants to prove herself as a musician in the amateur talent contest, and they figure if they can work together, they can both get what they want. S is for She Who Became the Sun by Shelley Parker Chan. This is epic historical fantasy set in China starting in 1345, and it follows Chu Chongba, whose brother was prophesied to achieve greatness. But when he's unceremoniously killed in a raid, Chu decides to pursue her desire for power and survival by assuming his name and his fate. T is for Tim Tamaro and the Subterranean Heartbreak Blues by H.S. Valley. It's supposed to be a satirical and humorous contemporary fantasy romance about Tim and Elliot, who go to the same magical school but cannot stand one another. However, when they're both dumped right before a major assignment, they reluctantly decide to work together and ditch their exes. U is for Light from Uncommon Stars by Riika Aoki. This is like a soft Faustian fantasy story about Shizuka, who's escaped damnation by making a deal with the devil to entice 7 other violin prodigies to sell their souls for success. After finding a potential final candidate, she meets a retired starship captain at a small donut shop, whose kindness and warmth makes her think that maybe there's more to life and a better way to break this curse. V is for none other than 1500 Miles from the Sun by Johnny Garzavilla. It's about a queer Chicane high school senior named Jules who is not planning to come out before he graduates. But when he gets a little bit too drunk at a party, he accidentally outs himself on Twitter for all his friends and family to see, and while his world is going to hell, his hot Twitter crush also slides into his DMs. W is obviously for The Witch King by H.E. Edgeman. It's a dark fantasy romance about a trans witch named Wyatt who was betrothed to the fairy prince as a child, but when he escapes from the fairy world and transitions as a man, he figures that he's effectively broken that contract. But when his fiancée Amir tracks him down in the human world, he has every intention of dragging Wyatt back so that they can secure the crown with their marriage, whether Wyatt wants to go or not. X is for Iron Widow by Jiran J. Zhao. It's about Zexian, whose country has been invaded by giant alien mechas, and humans have developed their own mechas to fight back. But these mechas have to be piloted by 2 people, usually a man and a woman, in a system where these female pilots are basically human sacrifices. Zexian's own sister was chosen to be a female concubine pilot and was killed, so now Zexian is willingly offering herself up as a concubine pilot so that she can kill the pilot responsible and destroy the system from the inside. Y is my biggest reach for this video because it's in the middle of a word when I really try to pull from the first letter, but it's The Passing Playbook by Isaac Fitzsimons. It's about a black trans boy named Spencer who is planning to go stealth at his new school, and he actually ends up getting drafted for the boys' soccer team, but because all of his legal documents don't match, he ends up getting benched. So now he must decide whether outing himself to fight back is going to be worth it. And finally, Z is for Gearbreakers by Zoe Hana Mikuta. It's a sci-fi story about a girl named Eris who lives in the Badlands, which is suffering under a tyrannical overlord who has these giant mechas known as windups. And Eris is a rebel who actually specializes in shutting down windups from the inside. On a mission gone wrong, Eris is captured and put in prison, where she meets Sona, a former windup pilot. Sona may not be as loyal to the windup program as Eris thinks, and the two of them reluctantly decide to work together on possibly their most dangerous mission yet. So there you have it. Those are 26 new queer releases from 2021 that should definitely be on your radar and that span the entirety of the Latin-based alphabet. There were obviously so many more books than I could actually include. I could have easily mentioned May the Best Man Win, Meet Cute Diary, Too Bright to See, Between Perfect and Real, Obi is Man Enough, and so many more. So leave me a comment down below and let me know which other books you think should be on this list. But that's everything I had to share for today. Thank you so much for watching, and until next time, educate yourself, be kind to yourself, take care of yourself, and I will catch you on the flip side of the page.